गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर हियर डिस्कसिंग द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी इन एग्रीकल्चर। इन दिस कंसर्न वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग फर्स्ट द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ पेस्ट रेजिस्टेंट प्लांट विद द हेल्प ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी। व्हाट ऑल प्लांट्स आर प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय बायोटेक्नोलॉजी विच आर पेस्ट रेजिस्टेंट, दैट इज बीटी कॉटन, बीटी कॉर्न, बीटी राइस, बीटी टोमैटो, बीटी पोटैटो एंड सोयाबीन बीटी ऑल्सो। Why this BT word is there? BT is the short form of a bacteria, Bacillus thuringiensis. This bacteria actually produces a toxin that is a BT toxin. This BT toxin can be cloned and this BT toxin can be expressed in the plants to make them resistant to the various insect, so that it can act as a biopesticide. And it is after introducing this gene into the plants have become resistant to the various insect, so that there is a no requirement of the chemical pesticide or insecticide. So this BT cotton or BT rice or BT tomato, BT potato and soybean, all of them are genetically modified plants. Now we are here coming how this can be prepared. So this is, I have converted it into the charts. First of all, this is the Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria is there. In Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria, there is a gene present. That gene is named as CRY gene. Here it is written CRY. Okay. So this gene is named as CRY gene. Now this CRY gene has 2-3 forms, like CRY1AC, CRY2AB. Okay. So CRY1AC and CRY2AB gene are there to control the bollworm. So this is the boll of the cotton plant. And this is been, a hole is been made or it is been attacked by the bollworm, so that this type of flower will not form if it is been attacked by the bollworm. So here they have written the cotton boll destroyed by the bollworm, a fully mature cotton boll. It is a fully mature, but if it is attacked, then this type of flower will not be formed. So this CRY gene is present actually in the Bacillus thuringiensis. The type of CRY gene are CRY1AC, CRY2AB. So these two are there to control the cotton bollworm, and CRY1AB controls the corn borer. This is one thing. Okay, now we are here coming to the back, that Bacillus thuringiensis is having a gene that is called as CRY gene. This CRY gene actually produces the CRY crystal. These CRY crystal are nothing but they are the insecticidal proteins. And these insecticidal proteins are present in the prototoxin form. But once any insect ingest this insecticidal protein, so in the insect body, in the presence of alkaline pH in the gut, this prototoxin which was there in the inactive stage, but in the presence of alkaline pH, this prototoxin will get activated and it will become active toxin. That means this crystal will get solubilized, and once these crystals of the protein will get solubilized, then they will bind with the midgut epithelial cell of the intestine. Okay, these crystals or toxin protein will bind with the epithelial cell, so that it will create the pores in the epithelial cell of the midgut, and it will also lead to the swelling in the midgut and also the lysis. Lysis means rupturing the cell. When cell will get ruptured and they will get swelled, the pores will be formed, so that ultimately it may lead to the death, and it can happen in the caterpillar stage itself. So what I have explained, this is all been written here. What all are the insects which causes the harm to the cotton plant? These are lepidopterians, these are tobacco budworm and army worm, coleopterians, beetles and diptarians, flies and mosquitoes. All of these insects are actually these insects which kills the, harms the plants, and for which the protection is required. So that now the biotechnological method is there by which the BT plants can be produced, and especially the BT cotton is being produced initially, and now it is very successfully growing. Okay, so this all which I have converted into the chart is been written here. So this is all about this plant. Now we are here coming to the another method. This another method is the pest resistant another plant. Okay, these two are totally separate question. Pest resistant plant. In this actually, what is the principle of this method? It is here written. You are to learn it as it is, that this method involves the silencing of the mRNA due to complementary double-stranded RNA molecule that binds and prevents the translation of the mRNA. That is called as mRNA silencing. So this method is mainly based on mRNA silencing. What is the meaning of this? That this double-stranded RNA is actually silent the mRNA so that no transcription will take place and no translation will take place and no protein will form. How do it happens? We are going to discuss it. Okay. So here actually what is there, that this is the nematode. What nematode is there? Melongnine ignosia. Nematode actually causes the disease to the tobacco plant. As I can show you the picture here, that if the tobacco roots are infected by this type of insect, then they become like this. These insects can be killed by the biotechnological method, and we can make the tobacco plant free of these nematode. Okay, it is a parasite only, and this type of parasite even cause the disease to the plants and animals and even to the human being also. But we are here discussing that how it causes the disease in the tobacco plant, and then how we can genetically modify the tobacco plant so that the nematode cannot survive in those plants which are genetically modified. How it will happen? So first of all, a gene is to be taken. Okay, and this gene is what? This gene is a nematode specific gene, and this nematode, the source of this gene can be a virus only. Okay, 2-3 organism are involved in this. The source of this complementary RNA could be from the infection by the virus having RNA genome or mobile genetic element transspoons that replicate via RNA intermediate. So what are they saying? Ki first of all, through the Agrobacterium tumefaciens, you should recall that Agrobacterium tumefaciens is a natural genetic engineer. Okay, so with the help of this Agrobacterium tumefaciens, a nematode specific gene is introduced into the host plant. Okay, host plant is what? Tobacco plant. At the introduction of gene means DNA. So introduction of nematode specific, again I am repeating, the source of this gene can be a virus. Okay, so nematode specific gene, if it is been introduced through the Agrobacterium tumefaciens into the host plant, to such that this DNA which is been introduced will now produce both sense and antisense RNA. This method is little bit complicated, but you look at here, ki through the Agrobacterium tumefaciens, the nematode specific gene is introduced into the host plant, and gene means what? DNA. So this DNA will produce both sense and antisense RNA, and these antisense and sense RNA, as they are complementary to each other, so that they will form double-stranded RNA. Now the principle of this method is there, ki this double-stranded RNA which is formed, this will interfere with the mRNA of the nematode, and this is called as RNA interference. RNA, it will silent the mRNA of the nematode, and this process is called as silencing of mRNA silencing. So that the condition is changed, and in these condition the nematode will not be able to survive. So it is been converted into the chart here, and the same is written here. I am reading, the Agrobacterium vector is used to introduce the nematode specific gene into the host plant. In the host plant, the DNA will produce both sense and antisense RNA. DNA means nematode specific gene only. So this will produce sense and antisense RNA. These two are complementary to each other.